Mats Madu, we are the children, we are the children of God. Come, 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 we change our world, we have what it takes to do it smart and make it smart. Welcome to our Smart Do.
Okay, welcome on board, class 8. I want to take you through a term known as immigration under the title external migration. External migration refers to movement of people in and out of a country. The word external, in and out. But when I'm referring to the word immigration, I'm using the word export. Let us start with immigration. Importation, from the word imports. Imports. The way you use the word imports, use immigration. So import, what is to import? It is to get a good from a country to your country. So with immigration, it is the movement of people. Movement of people from other countries. What can make a Chinese come to Kenya, import that? What can cause that immigration? That's what I'm calling immigration. So there are several things that are making people to migrate. Some are historical, others are modern. Number one, in the past, people like the Bantus were living in Congo. The Nilots were on the Nile, Bar and Hadazar. We have the Kushites, the Horn of Africa. The immigrated. So those are what we call early immigration. Early migration was as a result of livelihood, economic activity. Why do we live in the Congo region? We need farming land. Why do we leave the Horn of Africa or South Sudan? We need a place to graze our animals, or we need pasture and water. So, livelihood, economic activity, led to what we call the early migration. There is an error there. Led to early migration. Then from there, now what are other factors? One, we have early trade. The Arabs came to Eastern Africa for trade, and that is what I would call the early trade, because Africa had some items like gold, trade items like gold, ivory. So they migrated for early trade, and that's why most of the towns along the coast were established. Like towns of Mombasa, Malindi, those towns are the coastal towns, Dar es Salaam, Lidi, those towns around Mogadishu, those towns developed because of early trade, so people immigrated there. We also have the missionary work, the missionaries. Once the missionaries came to spread the gospels, we say they migrated. We were not Christians then, we are traditionists. And they migrated to bring the mission work. Then we also have the construction of Kenya-Uganda Railway. Construction of Kenya-Uganda Railway. Kenya-Uganda Railway. The Kenya-Uganda Railway, once it was established, just to draw a simple sketch. When it was established to open the interior to the coast, or to help people from the interior to access the coast because there were no roads. When this railway was established, the people who did the construction, it was funded by the British. It was funded by the British from Britain, but the workers came from India. So both the British who are funding it, number two, the Indians who are working in the railway line, all of them are immigrants. They came because of that railway lines. And after that, after the completion, most of the Indians never went back to their country. They established business along the railway line. And today they own some of the businesses. They became Ken citizens. We call them, they were known as the Dukawaras because they established the Dukas, the businesses, Dukawaras. So they immigrated that time. So we also have the colonization. The British came here as colonizers because they wanted to create control here and exhaust and benefit from the resources that were in the country, the minerals, the fertile soils. So the colonizers are immigrants. Some of them, even after colonization, never went back to their country. They acquired citizenship. Then we also have employment. Employment. There are people who have been employed in our country, mostly in the construction industry. You saw in the construction of the SGR, the most of the workers were Chinese, so they immigrated here as workers, employment. We have people who are working in this country as NGO people. We also have intermarried people. Kenyans have started marrying from other countries, intermarried. You get a Kenyan marrying a Congolese. So this the married person will become, or the married or the person marrying becomes an immigrant. We also have business opportunities, where they realize that when the people from outside world realize that they can invest here, they come here for that opportunity and they start an industry. A good example is the Magadi Company. The Soda Magadi Company that mines soda is a foreign company, it's a foreign owned Dini. It's not owned by the Kenyans. Then we have the civil wars. Civil wars. When countries fight, people run into a country as refugees. So the refugees are good examples of immigrants or people who have migrated to this country because of war. So there are so many other areas that you can exhaust. What can force people to leave their country and come to our country? Otherwise, go through the notes and have a good day. I use the flowers. Those people who live nearby flower farms, this is a flower farm. These people always get to the flower farm every day and work, then they get back to Bashambani, one rural area to another rural area. So employment, like the flower farms, have created employment. The other one is availability of land buying companies. People have formed groups. Maybe these people live in an area that is congested. They decide to form a group, an organization. Then they buy a land elsewhere, then they subdivide it among themselves. That is a land buying company. That's how some of the people vacated the native reserves. They formed land buying companies and went buying land elsewhere. The last one is irrigation scheme, establishment of an irrigation scheme, Once an irrigation scheme is established, people would move from areas that are dry to that area. This one I would call it rehabilitation. If a place was prone to diseases like the Rambo Valley, which has sacrificed, once the bushes were cleared, people went to live there. One rural area to another rural area. So those are some of the causes of rural urban migration, and therefore now we take you. Can people move from urban to urban? The answer is yes. What can make people hop from one town to another? Urban migration. What forces people from one town to another? The main one is employment opportunities. Employment opportunities. If someone was working in, let's say Mombasa, and they realize that in Mombasa I was working for a job that is 10,000 per month, What about if I get to Nairobi, the same job, I'm getting 40,000? So this person would tend to shift from this urban area, town, urban, to another urban. Why? Because of employment opportunities. Or maybe there is no more business here, so they get to the other one. The other one is business opportunities. Business opportunities. You realize that in a certain urban area, a certain product is on demand. While in another urban area, the case is different. Maybe, for example, if you happen to sell coconuts in Mombasa, the demand may not be very high because they are still there. But if someone is a coconut seller, this person might decide to bring it to Nairobi, where they don't grow the coconut. So the demand here will be a bit high. You have seen the opportunities to be more. Number two, there are businesses that you realize that in this small town, the population is small. But when I get to town, there are more people, and this business will boom. And those are what we are calling the causes of urban. The last one is insecurity. If a certain town has become prone to insecurity, people will tend to leave that town for another town. Otherwise, they are more in the north. Thank you for listening and have a good day.